Welcome students, so today we are going to learn about synthetic fibers and plastics. So in previous class I taught you fibers to fabrics. So dear students, so many things which you have seen around you, many things made up of from fibers and plastics. For an example, plates, toys, table, chair, toothbrush, many things. So you might have observed, whenever your mother is purchasing some clothes, so shopkeeper used to ask, which kind of material do you want, ma'am? Cotton, silk, rayon, which kind? So these all are fabrics, and now fabrics are made up of from fibers. Fibers are thin thread-like structure. Now fibers can be divided into two parts, natural fibers and synthetic fibers. In natural fibers, for an example, cotton, jute and woolen silk. Okay. So cotton we are getting from cotton plant, seeds of the cotton plant, and jute we are getting for skin of the stem, and silk we are getting from silkworm. Now in this chapter we are going to learn about synthetic fibers, but before starting the synthetic fibers we should know about monomers and polymers. Now what are monomers and polymers? You can see here small units are called monomers and the entire chain is called polymers. Okay, so here you can see this entire chain is called polymers and the small units are called monomers, and they join together and form particular substance. Now what is polymerization? The process by which the monomer molecules are linked to form a big polymer molecule is called polymerization. Okay. So for an example, if I am talking about nylon, you might have heard about the nylon, the strongest rope. Okay, so they are made up of from small units, and thus units are called amides. Okay, so here in nylon, small units are amides. So let's talk about synthetic fibers. In synthetic fibers, we will talk about rayon, nylon, polyester and acrylic. Dear students, though we are having natural fibers, then too we are making synthetic fibers. Why? Because synthetic fibers are cheaper than natural fibers, and artificial are polymers, we can change its property because it is under our control, or we can give a desired properties. So let's talk about rayon. Rayon was the first man-made fiber from a natural base material. That's why it is called semi-silk artificial fibers. Okay, why semi-artificial silk? Because it is made up of from wood pulp, and wood pulp is a natural fibers. Okay, and it appears like a silk. That's why it is cheaper than silk. That's why we are using rayon fibers to making lots of articles. For an example, shawls, carpets and materials and all. Okay, so this is first man-made fiber, but this is not fully man-made fiber. Now, what are the uses of rayon? Rayon is used for making tires, cots. It is also used for making carpets and surgical dressings, curtains and etc. Now, let's talk about nylon. Nylon is a strongest rope. Nylon is the another man-made fiber, but it is fully man-made fiber because it is not made up of from plants and animals. It is fully man-made fiber because here we are using coal, air and water. It is fully synthetic fibers. Now here I told you, here monomers are small units are amide. Okay, so don't be panic about the what is amide and what is the structure of amide. Just remember, here small units are monomers are amides. Okay, now what is the characteristics of nylon fiber? Nylon fiber is strong, elastic and light. It was lustrous and easy to wash, so it became very popular for making clothes. We use many articles made from nylon, such as socks, ropes, tents, toothbrush, car seats, belts and sleeping bags, curtains, etc. Now what are the uses of nylon fibers? Nylon is also used for making parachutes and rope for rock climbing, as nylon is stronger than a steel wire. That's why. So let's perform one activity so we can judge that nylon is a strongest fiber. Here I have taken one cotton cloth and some marble weights and taken one clamp also. So here gently put marbles one by one in the pan till the cotton thread breaks. Record the total number of marbles required to break the cotton thread. The total number of marbles required to break the cotton thread is measure of its tensile strength. How tensile strength it will measure? The more number of marbles to break the thread, it means it the thread tensile strength is more. So you can record your observation. Your observation that nylon thread hold maximum number of marbles before it breaks, followed by silk, cotton and wool. They are least strong. The thread which holds the maximum number of marble is the strongest fiber. Now you come to know that nylon is a strongest fiber. This is for you. This is this you can tabulate this cotton, the total weight required to break the thread. So this is this activity for you. Now polyester. Polyester is the another man-made fiber and it is made up of from ethyl monomers. Now ethyl we are getting from petrol. So the main compounds are where we can make polyester, that is air, water, coal and petrol. So from petrol we can make polyester. Polyester is another synthetic fiber. Fabric made from this fiber does not get wrinkle easily. It remains crisp and is easy to wash. So it is quite suitable for making dress material. You must have seen people wearing nice polyester shirts and other dresses. And here are the another substitute also, terricot and terrylene. They are substitute of polyester. Here polythene terephthalate. Polythene terephthalate PET. PET is very familiar from polyester. It is used for making bottles, utensils, films, wires and many other useful products. And the last fiber is synthetic fiber is acrylic. It resembles as a wool, but it is cheaper than wool. That's why we are using acrylic to make shawls, with shawls, jackets and sweaters. Many of these are actually not made from natural wool, though they appears to resemble wool. These are prepared from another type of synthetic fiber called acrylic. The wool obtained from natural sources is quite expensive. That's why we are using acrylic fiber. And here we from acrylic fibers, we used acrylic fibers to making sweaters, shawls, blankets, jackets and cushions, etc. So here we talk about the synthetic fibers. But how synthetic fibers are useful or not useful? What are the properties of synthetic fibers? And there are so many advantages of synthetic fiber. It is strong, elastic, lightweighted. It is very easy to carry everywhere, easy to wash. It is used for making socks, ropes, parachutes, many things. Okay, that's why we are using synthetic fibers. But we should know the disadvantage also. Let's perform another activity. Here I took two clothes, cotton and nylon cloth. Okay, then I take two mugs and same amount of water. Then I will dip both the clothes and I will see how much volume has been taken by both the clothes. So what I observed over here, I observed the volume of the water remaining in the container from which nylon cloth was removed is more than the volume of water remaining in the container from which cotton cloth was removed. It means nylon absorbs less water and it dries easily. Now here we talk about so many things of advantages and disadvantages. So advantages are, they are high tensile strength, that we performed one activity, lost water absorption, again we performed one activity, good elasticity, wrinkle resistant, because they do not easily wrinkle, okay, moth resistant and less expensive. But there are some disadvantages also. How disadvantages? Because it shrinks and melt when burned. It is very extremely risky to wearing synthetic clothes while cooking and while burning firecrackers. So it is always advisable wear cotton clothes whenever we are near the fires. Okay. And they do not absorb lots of water also. That's why, so what happened during hot days, you tend to get lots of sweat because the temperature of outside is quite high. That will not help to cool your body, so it is less comfortable to wear also. So here I have written some advantages and disadvantages. You come to know what are the advantages and disadvantages. So here we talk about the synthetic fibers. They are not biodegradable also. This is the main disadvantages. They are non-biodegradable. So here we can talk about now plastics. We discussed about synthetic fibers. Quickly talk about plastics. So where do we see plastics? You look around yourself. You will be able to see many things made up of from plastics. For an example, pens, table, so many things. Plastic plays very important role in our daily life. So why do we use plastics? Because it is easily molded to different shapes, because it takes any desirable shape, because it do not get rusted, they are lightweighted, they are poor conductor of heat and electricity, so they are very safer for the children's also, because it is less chances to getting electric shock also. So here you can see some plastics which you can see in your daily routine life. So plastics are two type, thermoplastics and thermosetting plastics. Thermoplastics, some plastics articles can bend easily while some break when forced to bend. When we add hot water to a plastic bottle, it gets deformed. That you have seen, and you might have performed this activity too. Such plastic which gets deformed easily on heating and can be bent easily are known as thermoplastics. Now let's talk about the thermosetting plastics. Thermosetting plastics, you might have seen switch sockets, and you might have seen your utensils, microwave utensils, melamine, bakelite and all. These all are thermosetting plastics. They do not get deformed by heat. Okay, so and they are very rigid. So here you can see some examples. For an example, Bakelite is a poor conductor of heat electricity. It is used for making electrical switches, handles of various utensils and all. And melamine also. Melamine is a versatile material. It resists fire and tolerates heat better than other plastics. It is used for making floor tiles, kitchenwares and fabrics which resist fires. Okay, melamine are made up of from nitrogen also. Bakelite and melamine, these are example of nitrogen content is more in bakelite and melamine. So you know that nitrogen is very important as a fertilizer, so we can obtain nitrogen from bakelite and melamine. But when we give heat to melamine and bakelite, it will expose some poisonous gas, so we cannot perform this activity. As you have seen, there are so many uses of plastics, because plastics are light, strong and durable. You can talk to your parents and grandparents how they were using plastics in their time. Plastics are non-reactive also. You know that metals like iron get rusted when left up exposed to moisture and air, but these plastics are non-reactive. They will not get easily corrode. Okay, plastics are poor conductor of electricity. That's why we are using all the utensils handles from plastics only. Now, we have talked about plastics. So, whenever we are talking about plastics, we always talk about good things of plastics. For an example, they are not good conductor of heat, less reactive, durable. Okay, so actually plastics are not good for our environment as we are using lots of plastic. That's why they are accumulate in our houses and garbages also, but they are not good for our environment. So here we need to understand what is biodegradable and what is non-biodegradable. Biodegradable means which is breakdown waste that can be degrade to simpler and harmless form is called biodegradable, and which cannot break down into simpler or harmless forms is called non-biodegradable. Okay, so where bacteria cannot decompose the substance is called non-biodegradable. Okay, and that is not good for our environment. Okay, plastic cannot be digested by human beings also. So, as decomposition is not possible for plastics, pesticides, DDT and all. So, lots of plastic being using and we are accumulating lots of plastic in our home, in our garbages also. A material which gets decomposed through natural process such as action by bacteria is called biodegradable. Now, plastic please save the environment. Since plastic takes several years to decompose, it is not environment friendly. It causes environmental pollution. Besides, the burning process in the synthetic material is quite slow and it does not get completely burned easily. In the process, it releases lots of poisonous fumes into the atmosphere, causing air pollution also. So, this is stable that you can see that peels of vegetable can biodegradable in within a 1 or 2 weeks, paper 10 to 30 days, or wood 10 to 15 days, but tin, aluminium, they 100 to 500, but plastic bags it takes several years to degrade or may not be. So here I come up with one solution. As a responsible citizen, remember 4 principles: reduce, reuse, recycle and recover. So how we will use? Reduce unnecessarily uses of plastics. You can use paper cups, paper bags also, and whenever possible, so kindly replace plastic from others. So here we can replace and we can reduce. I would suggest refuse this, but if we cannot, then reduce or reuse, recycle, use plastic in different forms. Waste segregation is must to recycle, means we can recycle the plastic also and reuse, use the same plastic again and again. We can use polythene bags again and again. Okay, and we can use the eco-friendly plastic also. Here is the bioplastic, which is made up of from corn and sugars. Okay, so plastic bags kills animals. Here you can see so many animals are in trouble because of plastics only, because they are non-biodegradable. So let's take one promise. I would request you all to take oath. Repeat after me. I pledge to refuse the use of plastic. I pledge to educate others about the plastic waste and harm it causes. I pledge to save my Mother Earth in every way I can. Okay, so this thing only we can save our environment. So do not throw plastic bags in the water bodies or on the road. Take cotton carry bags or a jute bag while going for shopping. Try to minimize the use of plastic materials. Example, use a steel lunchbox instead of plastic one. Thank you so much, students.